Yo, guys, welcome back to the channel. This is your boy Bashiro. Thank you so much for helping this channel reach 10k subscriber, boys. Thank you so much for your support. In this video, I want to teach you how to do Rom Lethal's Blue Roman Cancel Drift. This is such an important technique for Rom Lethal. And this video, anyone who wants to learn Ram Uke and mix up moving forward, they need to learn this technique. It is hard to pull off, however, it is such an effective technique to learn because this opens so much potential for mix-up, and this opens so much potential like for true 50-50s, especially in that corner, and you can convert into some really, really nasty stuff. So in this video, I'm planning to show you like how to do it and give you like some practical examples like why this is important. Moving forward with Ram's mixed videos, most of it will be relying on this one until we find like some other tech. So yeah. Okay, guys, without further ado, let's begin. Let's explain a little bit what does Blue Roman Cancel do and why it's such an important thing in Guilty Gear Strive. So, usually when you do the Blue Roman Cancel, there will be like a clock on your opponent. So, let me just show an example. So, I'll put here Sol, he's blocking everything. So, I put, after I hit any attack, he will do a DP, which is an invincible move. So, this helps you usually in training mode determine if there's like gaps in the... in your pressure or gaps in your offense. It means that your opponent can get out of it with an invincible move. So Blue Roman Cancel, actually it slows your opponent and still gives you some time to act. So if I do, for example, Blue Roman Cancel this into this, as you can see, Sol cannot really do something about it. But if I do it normally, he can interrupt me out of it. So now let's learn how you can actually do the Blue Roman Cancel. So for now, I'll just... basically, in for Rom Lethal, she has... two jump cancelable buttons, actually 5k and close slash. Usually when you do an attack and you follow it with a Roman cancel, you will get either the red Roman cancel, or if you really really delay the move, then you will get the purple Roman cancel. Since these attacks are jump cancelable, you can cancel like the jump into a Roman cancel, which invalidates the attack, if that makes any sense. So for example, if I do K and I jump, as you can see, it becomes a Blue Roman Cancel and the effects that we're talking about apply. However, for you to do like the most effective Blue Roman Cancel, you have to do it so low off the ground, and you need to combine it actually with a dash command. So what I recommend if you're playing on pad, I play on arcade stick, what I recommend on pad is put the dash command on one trigger and put the Roman Cancel on one trigger, and when you try to do it, do a blinking motion. A blinking motion, actually, it means that when you press a button and you follow up with the other one like half second later, it's like this. I'll try to slow it down in my camera. I know it's not the best thing. You do it like that. So the way that this happens actually is you will do a dash command, follow up by a Roman cancel. So the right input to do this BRC animation is you jump, you do a dash macro, then you do a Roman cancel. So that way your jump cancel will be Blue Roman canceled into a dash. So there is two Blue Roman cancel, dash Roman cancels for Rom Lethal. One that consumes your instant air dash. It means that you cannot backdash in the air. And the other one doesn't consume it. But you have really, really to be tight. So let me show you an example. So both of them actually, they can lead to true 50-50s. And some of them can also lead like... into a fuzzy guard situation. Fuzzy guard, it means that when you hit a crouching opponent, but they will be standing in the animation, so they will be hit by your high attack, even though it might not reach them if they're crouching. So as I explained, this is how it looks like. It's a little bit hard to pull off, but what you can do actually is, like I said, so that one you can actually go into either a high or a low, and if you do it a little bit high off the ground, you can backdash and you can do like a true 50-50. So if you do the one without the air dash, what you can do is something like that. So you don't allow your opponent to attack. So what you can actually do also is this one, like that. You know, so that's why it's so filthy actually. You can also do something like that. So there's a lot of options actually. And now I'll show you how you can implement it into your gameplay and into your mix-up. So, as I said, cancel your dash into a Roman cancel while jumping, and do it like in a blinking motion. It means that you press dash and like almost immediately, not at the same time, almost immediately, you press the Roman cancel button. That's why macros are so important in this game. Yeah, so if you want to do it from a jump cancelable button, like a slash or a kick, the timing is really different. Because if you try to do it immediately, like unlike the row, it will actually either come like as a blue Roman cancel, red Roman cancel, or you will jump and nothing will happen if you try to do it like that. So what you need to do actually is you need to wait for the animation a little bit of the K or the close slash to come out, then you need to do it. So it's all about waiting. I will slow it down in editing so you can, like, in hopes just to teach you like what is the exact timing. And you can still either do it like really, really fast and retain your instant air dash if you want to backdash, or you want to do an attack into another dash, or you can actually just consume the instant air dash so you can go for a fuzzy setup. So I'll just try to show an example now. So as you can see, one example, we did like a backdash really, really quickly to the back just to do like an overhead, and the other one, it went to a fuzzy setup. And you can actually go for like 50-50 lows. So you can see how really, really this is strong. So if you combine it with salt pressure, it's really, really powerful. Throw 50-50s, and especially if your opponent doesn't have like reversibles, it's really, really hard for them to go out of it. So it's basically a guessing game for them. The other thing actually is that even if your opponent has an invincible reversal, if you do the BRC, you can actually just react. It will be a safe jump. So let me show an example. We'll let our buddy Sol here on block. He will do a DP. I know this is not like the best way to show it, يعني, but we'll try. So if I do that and I attack, as you can see, Sol will do the the volcanic viper. So as you can see, even if you attempt to do it, you're still safe on block. So you're still safe. They cannot DP out of it. So let me show you just like really, really, really quick, like let's call practical applications that you can do. I'm going to be making a separate video where to show like the actual setups. But I just want to make sure that video is really high quality, because I don't want to teach things that has gaps or that are not really practical. So I'll work on this more, let it cook in the oven, and I'm going to be releasing some really, really nice tricks with Ram Lethal. I'm spending more time in training than anything else. So let's show now like really, really quick applications. So yeah, guys, that's it for this video. I hope this is really helpful. This is a really, really important technique that you need to learn for Ram. And I feel like this is her basis for awesome pressure. I really am excited now, to be honest, because even though we lost like the easy 50-50s, I feel like this is the true 50-50s. It's a guessing game for your opponent, guys. Ram Lethal will be number one. My goal for this drive is actually to raise the Ram Lethal army. So yeah, guys, if you have any questions, let me know in the comment section below. Hopefully this video will help you out. This is not easy, to be honest, to do. But once you practice it, like, and you have enough time, like, and you cook it enough in the oven, you will start to do it consistently. And there is a lot of tight things that you can do. So look for more future videos, guys. Again, guys, thank you for the 10,000 subs. And I'll catch you in the next video. This is your boy Bashiro. Yalla, peace.